Welcome back to Know for Perspectives. Yes, I guess spring is around the corner because the taste of Hampton Roads is coming back to Hampton Roads. And I got to talk to Debbie Mergy. How's it going?
Oh, it's so amazing. Can you believe that we are actually going to celebrate our 25th anniversary of presenting Taste of Hampton Roads? I am so very excited, and to see the culinary community come together with what we do every day. We both are feeding people, and we're going to come together and say, come to our table so that we can feed others.
And I think, you know, having fun, and it really has become an institutional night of really having fun and bringing the whole community together, to talk about something that's kind of serious and intense.
It's very serious.
We do have a problem.
It's very serious.
People being fed in today's economy.
Yes, we do. And to know that in that one night, we were able to provide over 600,000 meals with Taste of Hampton Roads last year.
Wow.
So it's hugely important to come and have fun, but to know that you're supporting the effort that we are feeding people in our community.
Okay, now I'm the perfect one for you two to be talking to, because I'll come home at night and say, well, what are we going to have for dinner? We open up the, oh, we don't have anything in there. Well, we do, but it's not something we want to cook, or we don't want to have to clean up. It's a convenience for us. So where do we head off but to one of our local awesome restaurants we have here in Norfolk and throughout Hampton Roads? But that's not a choice for some people.
It's not a choice. It's not a choice at all. But these people help make it happen.
Okay. And Jennifer Lalonde?
Lalonde.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You're the one this year that was given the task to line up people like Carlos.
That's right.
How hard was it to do? Was it a hard assignment?
Actually, I would have to say we are blessed with the community pouring out. And this is the first year that we've had a waiting list for restaurants and catering and culinary participants in general, culinary businesses wanting to be involved with this event.
Okay, well, let me make things real clear here. A waiting list to come and serve people 2 ounces of their food at a time, and they're not going to really get paid for it.
That's right. And it is a great amount of work. Because you need to show your best. Your restaurant wants to put their best foot forward. But it's a great win for the restaurants that are involved as well. It's great exposure for them and the ability to use their skill set to do something good for the community, to make a difference, to try to solve hunger, and at the same time expose their businesses, such as wonderful restaurants like Menino's, that has award-winning she crab soup and many other delectable things.
Which you don't really need a spoon for. You can just kind of, can you slurp it?
You can,
but you might miss all the crab in the bottom. So.
Okay. Now, so Jennifer thought she was bringing a ringer in by having you sit on the sofa,
right?
Because then I wouldn't ask her who the other 41 restaurants are, right?
Right.
Go for
the case?
I got the list.
Oh my! That's not fair.
If I miss someone, I'd feel terrible. But you can look for our rack cards around town. There are many of the participants' business places, and also at the website, which is www.tasteofhamptonroads.org. All of them are listed there as well, with links to their website, so you can take a look at their menus.
Okay, we got off to a late start doing this segment because during the pre-tease, I was trying to figure out what you're preparing. Fork. Spoon? No.
That I do not know yet. It's a surprise for everyone.
Including you.
Exactly, including me.
And that's what's really cool about this evening, because it can really lead to all kinds of new relationships, because you're kind of crossing all over the place. And then if you're not really into going out to dinner, and you really are into cleaning out the refrigerator and fixing something at home, you've got a special gift too, right? That you guys are launching on.
Well, I guess you can use it for that.
You could cook from it if you wanted to.
You could cook. Mm-hmm. I think the great thing about the cookbook that we offer, it's a yearbook of the event for the year that it's covering. So this is last year's event. And in that, you're going to see facts about the food bank. You're going to see pictures of the different things that we do. You're going to see the sponsors that have supported us. And the best part is all the recipes that are given from all the participating restaurants. So it's a huge keepsake. It's wonderful. It's fun. And every VIP ticket holder will receive one of these after the event.
And how does one become a VIP holder?
If you will go to www.tasteofhamptonroads.org, you may purchase a ticket there, or you can certainly look at the partnership packages that have great marketing opportunities, as well as be able to have tickets included with that.
Super.
And this event does sell out every year, both the VIP as well as the general admission. So people do not want to wait. They want to go and get those tickets.
Get those tickets right now. March 4th at the Virginia Beach Convention Center. It's a great time for the region to come together and talk about, but also get engaged in solving a problem. And you know, that's what viewers for Norfolk Perspectives do. They solve problems. And we want to hear from you what you'd like to see on TV 48. But more importantly, what's going on in your neighborhood? Give us a holler at 664-6510. And as usual, it's a wonderful time to be in Norfolk just because of you and you.
Thank you.
Sir.